Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart the Prince of Wales and welcome to a review video from Telltale Games' Tales from the Borderlands. Cue intro video. Okay, so this is the very first episode released in Telltale Games' Tales from the Borderlands and it is called Zero Sum. Now, I have never played any of the Borderlands games previously, so I was completely brand new playing this Let's Play, and to be honest, I was pleasantly surprised. It was interesting. No, to begin with, we'll talk about the story, and basically, you start off as Rhys. He is this very arrogant, very confident prick, to be honest with you, and I love characters like that, and it was interesting to play as him, and some of the reactions that you could actually select were pretty good. For example, you can kick a kind of rubbish bin over, you can badmouth your boss, you know, you can pick on your best friend, and this was all within the first kind of half hour or so of the game, and it was great. It was a great sort of introduction to him as a character, and basically what the story is, you're up in space on the spaceship, and I do apologise to any fans of the Borderlands that know the names of the ships and the planets and stuff, but I'm kind of not used to it, so I may get a few things wrong, but if so, I do apologise. Basically, you start off on the ship above the planet, I think the planet was called Pandora, and basically you're due for a promotion as Rhys, but this new guy comes in as the boss called Vasquez, who absolutely hates you, and he basically screws you over and says, right, you're going to become a janitor, you're promoted to be in the janitor, and you completely flip out. But anyway, the whole kind of plot device is you trying to get your own back on him. You end up overhearing a deal at the start of the game, and that means that you try to hijack the deal. The deal's worth, I think it's £10 million or something like that, so you end up travelling to the planet with your best friend. Your best friend is a small geeky guy, I can't remember his name, I can't remember what it was, but basically he's a small kind of nerdy geeky guy, very good with computers, and he comes down there and assists you, and it's like a little enlarged kind of tag team. Basically you're down there on the planet, you're causing mayhem and mischief, and this is a very cool scene about halfway through where your other friend who stays up on the ship upstairs basically sends a loader bot to help you. And a loader bot is this massive kind of robot with lots of rockets and lasers and stuff, and they basically send that loader bot down to Pandora to help you try to defeat the bandits that are on the planet. There are lots and lots of bandits on Pandora. Pandora is this desolate kind of wasteland of a planet, basically. Think of Tatooine from Star Wars. Think of the cantina and the type of people who get in that cantina. That's basically what Pandora is. And you know, it's great. But then halfway through the game, you end up playing Fiona, who basically takes over the other half of the story. Basically, they both converge halfway through. And Fiona is also not a nice person, much like Rhys. She is a con artist. She takes great pleasure in trying to make a profit. And she basically, her and her sister, and they've got like a friend who's like a father figure to them, and I can't remember his name. And they're on this like camper van, and they basically plot in a way of how they can get this deal to work in their favour, and how they can earn £10 million, even though the thing they're selling is a vault key. It's fake, it's not a real vault key, and yeah, that's basically the whole kind of plot, which is a pretty basic plot by Telltale standards, but it works so well. I mean, the amount of comedy in this game was insane. You know, when you think of games like The Walking Dead and Game of Thrones by Telltale, they are much, much darker, grittier, and this game is much more lighthearted. It is gritty in its own way, but it's very lighthearted, and you know, I am looking forward to playing the next episode when that's released. It'll probably be released, I imagine it will probably be February, so something to look forward to next year when that's released, and I'll definitely be doing... Well, I'll definitely be continuing my Let's Play and doing episode 2 on my channel. So now we'll talk a little bit about the gameplay and pretty much your standard Telltale Games formula, point-and-click adventure game. You have, you know, different characters, point of views that you play as in this game. Like I've mentioned previously, it's Fiona and Rhys. Different dialogue options as well. So the only thing I would say is I don't think the options that I picked, and this goes for the Game of Thrones as well and most of the other Telltale games, to be honest, I don't think most of the options that I do pick have much of a bearing on the overall plot. It's basically, it's like you're trying to get from point A to point B, but but there are different routes to get to point B, and that's basically all it is. And it's the same thing that applies here, really. No matter what you say, it does seem, although I haven't played, I've only played the episode once, so I don't know for certain, but it does seem that whatever choices you pick will pretty much put you in the same place for the end of the episode and ready for episode 2. But it's interesting to see what happens in episode 2 when that begins, and that will probably be, like I said, probably end of January, beginning of February, I imagine. It's usually 4, 5, sometimes 6 weeks until they release. So now we will conclude, time for a conclusion, and you know, like with the Game of Thrones by Telltale Games, I'm not going to give this game a rating just yet because one episode, and I do believe there's going to be 5 episodes in this series, so I can't give it a rating. But what I will say is, if you're a fan of the Borderlands, and I'm sure you'll love this, if you're a fan of Telltale Games like myself, then I'm sure you'll love this as well. I think it's great, it's lighthearted, and something completely different to the other games that they've done in the franchise so far. Anyway, folks, I've been Dragonheart. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.